The following is a class from the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, Volume 8, Chapter 20, Text 294 through 298, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 19, 1966, in New York.
Tritiya Purusha Vishnu Gunavatar दुई अवतार की तौर गणना तहा विराट दृष्टि जीवेर तेह अंतर्जामी हिरोदक्षाई तेह पालन कर्ता स्वामी सो गर्भोदक्षाई विष्णु देन नेक्स्ट विष्णु द थर्ड इनकार्नेशन इज हिरोदक्षाई विष्णु within this universe, there is a planet near the pole star, which is called Kirodakshayi planet, and there Lord Vishnu, in his incarnation of Antarjami, super soul, he is acting as the super soul. And he is the universal form. When you think of universal form of the Lord, that is the manifestation of this Kirodakshayi Vishnu. And that Kirodakshayi Vishnu, as Paramatma, Super Soul, is situated in everyone's heart, even within the atom. Annantarastham Paramanu Chayantarastham. Paramanu means atom. And within the atom also, we think of God as very great universal form, but God can take also form less than the atom. That is God's power. He is not only great, greatest, but He is the smallest. Anuraniyana mahatomahiyana. Mahatomahiyana is greatest of the great. And Anu and Yang and smallest of the small. We cannot think how small he can become. That is his inconceivable potency. So within this material world, he is within the atom and he is within everyone's heart, in everywhere, all pervading, and at the same time, universal form, the biggest form. विराट भस्ति जीवेर तेह अंतर्जामी किरोदक्षाई तेह पालन करता स्वामी नाउ ही इज द मेंटेनर ऑफ वट एवर वी आर एंजॉइंग इट इज ड्यू टू हिज मर्सी इन द कठोपनिषद मांडुक्य उपनिषद इट इज स्टेटेड नित्या नित्यानाम चेतना चेतनानाम एक बहुनाम विदधाति कामान Now, He is the supplier. Whatever we want. As a palankarta, as the maintainer, as the super soul, He supplies. He's supplying whatever you want. All right. So, we should not approach God as supplying agent. That is the lowest stage. He is supplying even to the cats and dogs. Then what is the difference between human being and the cats and dogs? Just like a small child, he is supplied all necessities by the father. But when the child is grown, he wants to serve the father. Similarly, to make God as order supplier, oh God, give us this, give us that. Then God is giving. You ask or not ask, He will give you. Because after all, you are all children. So He takes care of His children. You may say that why the children are differently treated? somebody is supplied sumptuously and somebody is not. Why this difference of treatment? That difference of treatment is also for good. How? Just like a mother has got 5 children. One of them is suffering from fever, is ill. Now, very nice foodstuff is prepared. All the children come and mother is supplying. And when the fever is chill, child comes, oh, you don't sit here. You cannot take. Oh. Why? Oh, you are diseased. You cannot take. Do you think that mother is partial to this child and that child? No. Anyone who is not supplied as he wants, that is due to his own disease, chronic. So, if God does not supply him sufficiently, it is good for him. Therefore, in spiritual advancement, a poor man is in more advantage because he can think of God, provided he is virtuous. He'll think of God. Chaturvidha bhajante maam sukriti narjuna. So this supplying, God is supplying. Eka bhunam vidhati kaman. That one, there are two living entities, one supreme and other. One singular number, other plural. We are among the plural number. Nitya nityanam. Nityanam, this is plural number. Amongst many eternals, so we are amongst the many, many eternals. We are also eternal. We have got that qualitative, thing. Eternity is the same quality as of God, as of ours. We are eternal. God is eternal. That's all. But we are amongst the plural number. Nitya, nityana. And he is the singular number. And it is particularly stated that eka, that singular number, eternal purusha, he is supplying everyone's necessities. So God is supplying everyone's necessities. Either you are a cat or dog or demigod or President Johnson or anyone. Everyone is dependent on God's supply. We cannot be independent. And if God stops supplying, you cannot manufacture. If there is food grains, there is no food grain, you cannot chew your dollar notes. What will you do, your $100 notes? So he is the supply. Eka bhuna viradati kama. So we should be, this is knowledge of God. We should be in love of God means. So God has supplied us so many things. And why not? Therefore, pure devotees, they like to supply God. They want to become order supplier of God, not to make God as order supplier. What God wants that make everyone God conscious, Krishna conscious. He sends his son, he sends his books, he comes himself, that is his mission. He wants that all these suffering living entities, they should become Krishna conscious and be happy. God wants it. The Bhagavad Gita is clearly stated. So if you want to supply the want of God, God wants it, if you become yourself Krishna conscious and try to serve God by spreading this mission all over the world. That is the best service. That is the best service to the Lord. To become yourself field worker. God is very much anxious to get back his mad sons. In this material world, everyone is mad, crazy. It is a defense of degrees only. I may be more crazy than yourself. But we are all crazy. And as soon as we are fixed up in Krishna consciousness, our craziness is vanished. Yes. That is our constitutional position. The part is to serve the whole. We are part and parcel. So this is a chance. This manifestation of this material world is a chance to have that opportunity. And especially this human form of life is a boon for understanding this Krishna consciousness. If we miss this opportunity, then we are unfortunate. Purushavatare koinu nirupan lilavatare vishnu sanatan. Now Lord Chaitanya says, now I have described about the three Purusha incarnations. What is that? Mahavishnu, Karanarnam Sai Vishnu or Mahavishnu, then Garbhodaka Sai or Hiranyagarbha, Kirodaka Sai or the Super Soul, Antarjam. The three Vishnu incarnation description is finished. Now he is trying to explain Leelavata, past times. God has got all propensities. So if he wants to fulfill some propensity, then he comes here to exhibit, to manifest that. Just like God comes here, just Ramachandra, Lord Ramachandra. And what was the main function of Lord Ramachandra? He fought with Ravan, his enemy. So this is called Leela. What is that Leela? Leela pastime. When God wants to have some desire to fulfill that I should fight. Sometimes you feel mock fighting with friends or it is your children. Similarly, where from this desire comes unless the desire is in God? Because He is the origin of all everything. So don't you feel sometimes mock fighting? There is enjoyment. Fighting with friends, boxing. That is not fighting, that is enjoyment. Similarly, God wants to enjoy by fighting. So Vaikuntha there is no fighting, because there is nobody can be found there, enemy. Everyone is obedient servant. Therefore he comes here, to find out some enemy. The two functions are served. Paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya cha diskita. He satisfies his fighting spirit, at the same time he protects the devotees and protects that enemy also by killing him. Because when a demon is killed by the Supreme Lord, he is at once liberated. The liberation which he had to achieve after many, many births, he at once achieves. That is the advantage. So he saves the enemy and saves the devotee, and stands at the same time he satisfies his fighting desire. So God is good, so any fight, that is also good. It is not that Krishna is inducing, inciting Arjuna to fight. There is a plan, big plan. So foolish people who criticize, oh, Krishna is inciting war. We are very good men, non-violence. So this good man has no value. That fighting has much value. But there is a plan, good plan. So this is called pastime, Leela, Leelavata. So what are the Leelavatas? Lord Chaitanya says, Lilavatar Krishna Najaya Katham. How many number of Lilavataras are there, and nobody can count. God is unlimited, so anything manifested by Him is unlimited. That cannot be calculated by us. So there are so many Lilavataras. Pradhan kohiya kohi digdarasa. Some of them I am just mentioning. Nobody can, I will say, fully calculate or understand how many Lilavataras are there and where it is going and how it is going on. But it is going on. The same example, that the sun is always in the sky. Now where it is, that you have to find out. But sun is always in the sky. Similarly, the Lilavatar is always there. Just like Krishna, in this planet Krishna is not present, but in some of the universe He is present. His avatar is going on. He's going on. In every minute, every second, He's taking His birth and He's fighting in the Kurukshetra. That is called Nitya Lila. Eternal. His everything is eternal. He is eternal. Whatever He does, that is also eternal. And because we are conditioned, we cannot understand His eternity, His unlimitedness. But He is unlimited, His everything is unlimited. So Lord Chaitanya confirms there that how many Lilavatars, incarnations are there. We want to everything make limited. Because we are all limited sense, limited understanding, limited, everything is limited. And God is unlimited. That we do not understand. We try to understand God with our limited means. That is our folly. Therefore we don't believe, oh God is doing like that, or God is lifting hill. How is this possible? This is story. Why is this story? God is omnipotent and God cannot lift a hill. He is floating so many planets in the air, weightlessness, and He cannot lift a hill. Because I don't believe that He is God. Abhijananti mahamurha. Foolish rascals, they consider me as ordinary man, not Krishna, but me. So offer your respect to me. I am God. I am competitor of Krishna. So these are foolishness. He is unlimited. Everything is unlimited. Now, Lord Chaitanya mentioning some of his main features of this Lilavatha. Matsa, Kurma, Raghunath, Nishinga, Bhaman, Baraha adi, Lekha jaya, na jaya gana. Some of the principle of avatar, they are mentioned. Matsavata. During Vaivarshata Mano, there was devastation. And in that devastation, Lord took Matsavata, incarnation of fish, and He protected the Vedas. Pralaya payad hijali dhitavan si Vedam. Vihita-vahitra-charitra-makhedam kesa-vathita-meena-sarira-jaya-jagadi-sahari. The poet Jayadeva, the great devotee poet, is singing. Then in the devastation, my Lord Kesha, You have assumed the form of peace. The great Muni was sitting, He was meditating. And after taking His birth in the ocean, in the sea, He brought one pot of kumandal. Kumandal, that pot you have seen. He found a little fish there. Then within few seconds, that fish covered all the pot. And the Muni thought, he's growing so rapidly. All right, let him have some big pot. So he gave him book, big pot. Then again he became full. Then in this way, he has to put it in the ocean, and he became ocean-like. Then he understood that he is God. So this is godly power. He can take the shape as the ocean is big, so he can take the bigger than the ocean form. But he is the maker of all form. He has made ocean. But it is very, very difficult to understand how God becomes fish. But that does not mean that every fish is God. No. So there is Matsavata. Pralaya paradhijali dhitavanasi vedam vihitavahitra charitramakhedam. Similarly, he took the incarnation of tortoise, kurma. There was a churning of the ocean, and the churning rod must be rested on something solid. So he became the churning rod resting, and the hill, Mandar hill, was placed. And he was feeling some itching sensation. So it was nicely itched by churning rod. So this is his kurma avatar. Then Raghunath is Ram, Lord Ram. He came to kill that Dashanan, who had 10 faces. Vitarashi dikshirani dikpatikamaniyam. So, in this way, there are innumerable incarnation of pastime. Nishinga. Tavakara kamalavari nakamadhuta singam dalita hiranna kasiputanu bringam kesavadhita narahari rupa jaya jagadisa hari. Nishinga means half lion and half man. And this shape was assumed by the Lord to kill Hiranyakashipu, the father of Brahma, father of Prahlad. Prahlad was a great devotee of Lord, and his only fault was that he was a great devotee. His father wanted to kill him. So it is very dangerous also to become devotee. Even the father will be prepared to kill him. Mother will be prepared to kill him. And what to speak of others complaining, "Oh, Swamiji, you are disturbing our sleep." So, although we have made our friendship with Krishna and he will always protect us, but at the same time, this devotional line is risky also, that we create so many enemies. There are many examples in the history of this devotional service that unnecessarily people become enemy to this innocent devotee. Even an innocent boy like Prahlad Maharaj, 5 years old, but a devotee cannot give up his profession. He was being chastised so many times by his atheistic father. But what Prahlad Maharaj was doing, he was king, he ordered the teachers that this boy is coming home and chanting Hare Krishna. What is this nonsense? Teachers asked. Teachers said, "My dear sir, we do not teach Hare Krishna. According to your regulation, we are secular. There is no possibility of teaching God or God's name. This boy, I do not know where from he has got this Hare Krishna." he became very angry. "Where you have got your Hare Krishna? Father, from where you have got your anger? I have got Hare Krishna." He is the supplier. You want to be angry, he supplies anger. And I want to chant, now he becomes more angry. So, but that boy, what was he was doing? That the teacher was forbidden, secular, and the father was enemy. Still he was taking the opportunity. As soon as the teacher is out, oh my dear friends, come on, I shall preach to you, Hare Krishna, and his son. So this should be all your policy. Whenever there is some chance, just preach this. Whenever there is chance. But you should always know that you will find enemies. But you don't be afraid. God is your own. The Prahlad Maharaj, he was such a nice devotee. And to protect him when he was just going to be killed by his father. And his father was very good politician. He took a benediction from Brahma that he will not be killed by anyone. I shall not be killed by man, oh yes. I shall not be killed by demigods, that's all right. I shall not be killed by any animal, that's all right. I shall not be killed in day, that's all right. I shall not be killed at night, that's all right. I shall not be killed by any weapon, that's all right. And he's now in his face. Everything is now secure. I cannot be killed in day, I cannot be killed at night. No man can kill him, no demigod can kill me, no animal can kill me. Then where is the killing? Everything finished. But God is so cunning that he assumed neither man nor animal and no weapons. He killed him with the nails. He never expected that I'll be killed by the nails. This is the definition by negation. Defective definition. An argument, if you define negatively, this is not this, then something will come that will nullify all your arguments. So he protected himself in all negative ways. This will not. Something came which was not in his power. So this Nisinga avatar, then Bhavana avatar I have already mentioned, that he became a dwarf Brahmin boy and took all the position that Maharaj Bali. This Maharaj Bali was grandson of this Maharaj Prahlad. So these are lila avatar, pastimes. Pastimes means exchange of dealing between the devotees and the Lord, between the living entities and the Lord. Exchange. Either there are 12 kinds of human rasas. Sometimes he deals as enemy, sometimes he deals as friend, sometimes he deals as so many things, there are 12. So we are all related with God in some human out of these 12, either as enemy or as friend or servitor or lover or as son or father, as the master and servant, in so many ways we are related. And when these relationships exchange between God and the living entity, and that is called lila, pastimes. So lila avatar. Thank you.